First strikeout for Bill Conkling. Two down now, one on. Bottom of the sixth. Chad White will come back up. Boom.
Doing a lot of breaking balls.
Chad White walked and scored a run his last time up. Conkling continues to come with the breaking ball.
Well, the general rule of thumb is to go up looking for a fastball and adjust to the curve. It's still what I would do against Conkling, but you could almost guess on a few of these, he's going to come in with the curve and sit back, and if he leaves it out over the middle of the plate, you could send it out there somewhere.
Here's a drive down the right field line. Champion on his horse, and he gets there. So Conkling, a strong inning here in the bottom of the sixth. Score stays the same, 5-2 Maine.
For exciting sports, follow America's top amateur athletes on the USOC Olympic Sports Series. Hoops fans won't miss a beat with our exclusive national coverage of the World Basketball League. We'll canvas the world of sports and the world at large on World of International Sports. Your weekends are piston-powered with fast-paced NASCAR action and Monday night sizzle with a pro boxing tour. Turn on Sports Channel America for exciting sports.
Heading into the seventh inning here, 5-2 Maine. The Black Bears looking to advance. Jim Dillon doing the job on the hill for the University of Maine here in the second game. He has retired 8 in a row, settled down after a rocky start. And has at last cooled the hot bats of Fordham, who had scored 32 runs in the previous 20 innings.
He's been the difference together with, of course, the trio of home runs. Taylor, Hartung, and Sweeney connecting. So the combination of those two things have the Black Bears in command in this game, but three runs to the Fordham team.
Not much in that first game, that's for sure. Jim McDermott's been on base a couple of times with a single and a walk. Looks at the strike.
Felt that was in tight, but then he puts the nod on. We talked about that, and I think Dillon, would you agree, he's done a better job of coming inside on hitters in this game. He's had some strikes and gotten inside once in a while, and that wasn't happening in the first game.
At least has him thinking. Ground ball out to second. Scott over to DeLucia. One down.
This is pretty solid infield defense for Maine. Not a team that makes a lot of mistakes, and Fordham's been very solid defensively as well. McDermott gets the bat head out on this one and drives it. And Tim Scott just eats it up out at second base. Notice the infielders with the gloves down, come up to react, and this man is on a roll right now, Jim Dillon.
Santi Galone doubled to lead off this second game and scored. But is grounded out to the pitcher and then grounded out again, deflected off the pitcher and thrown out by the shortstop, Brian Seguin.
That was quite a play by Seguin. Just got Galone at first.
That's what you were just mentioning. Dillon's keeping him honest.
See, that ball wasn't even really that inside, but the way these Fordham guys drive into the ball, it ended up being very close to him.
You could move some of these Fordham kids back and still throw a strike.
Oh, yeah.
They're really right in there. Galone fouls that one back. The count goes to 1-1.
Galone is one of them. Looks like he might have hurt himself the other way he ran out of the batter's box. He is sore in some way. I don't know.
Little squibbler down a third. Knocks. Nice play.
Just barely. I think Gallone has got a sore wrist, Mike. He made a diving stop on a ground ball. And
nice play here. Watch Dillon hop the ball, and Knox never loses concentration.
I think that's why he tries to bunt this one. This is just a fine play on the move and a good stretch over there by DeLucia.
Two down, and Pete DeLuca steps to the plate.
DeLuca and DeLucia, both first basemen.
There, the streak is broken. Solid single to center field for Pete DeLuca after Jim Dillon had put down 10 in a row.
DeLuca has swung a good solid bat today. Stays in there. Good solid rip into center field.
Mike Ancolari, the DH, comes up. He has struck out twice and singled against Jim Dillon. Dillon misses outside ball one.
Well, that's where Ancolari has been seeing the ball all afternoon from Dillon, right on the outside corner.
Same result, 2-0.
I mean, if I'm Ancolari, I'm gonna probably get closer to the plate. He is painting the outside corner against him, and he has every time up, and he just seems to just not be able to reach it.
Reno. Amazing, you see a pitcher just rolling along in a groove, then someone gets a single, and all of a sudden he's lost it for a batter or two.
That's right. You're just out of that rhythm. Before that, it's give me the ball and let me mow down the hitters. He's trying to be a little too fine here with Ancolari, I think. He's just trying to nip that outside corner instead of just going right after him.
Stayed outside and caught it that time, 3-1.
Well, that must be the scouting report on him, because Ender is just camped on the outside corner.
And he misses outside, so all five of the pitches outside, and all of a sudden Fordham now brings the tying run to the plate. Two on, two out.
Look who's coming up.
Mr. Montgomery. One for three here today, and then we see Dillon missing again outside on Ancolari. So Montgomery, the tying run for Fordham as he steps in.
Hit four home runs this year. Fordham is really more of a line drive hitting team. As a team in the regular season, they hit 30 home runs. That's compared to 55 for Maine.
Ball two. And John Winken gonna take a little walk to the mound. Jim Dillon again had been rolling along, retiring 10 in a row, and then a hard single to center field by DeLuca. Ancolari draws a walk, and now a 2-0 count on Montgomery. Coach just out there to give him a little encouragement. Quick pat. And Dr. John will head back to the dugout.
Coaches can just sense that when the right time, see their pitcher reeling to go out and just give him a word of confidence. Tell him not to be too fine. Just go in there and challenge the hitters the way he has. And of course, against this guy, don't lay one right in there either. But be aggressive.
Up there swinging.
I'll say. I think he he knew he was going to take a hack at that one when it came in.
Two balls, one strike, and he wants to tie.
Gave him a break, too. That was ball three. She said, oh, I'm going to go after it. It's up. Not much he could do with that one. High and tight. Wanted to tie this ball game up with one fell swoop.
Mm-hmm. Two balls, one strike, two out, two on. 5-2 Maine. Top of the seventh. There's a drive, long and foul down the left field side. That's parking lot material.
Well, you get out in front of that one. The pitcher throws it inside, and you say, don't be throwing it in there on me. Just nail it there, foul.
Sean Winken, glad that Montgomery didn't wait a split second more on that. Got it around the shoulder, maybe?
Or maybe the forearm as he's leaning in.
It loads the bases for Fordham with two outs. Let's take a look.
It's going to just ride in. Montgomery doesn't realize it's going to come in that far, and it looks like it may have caught the right
forearm in.
The right forearm.
Unusual place to be hit.
Yeah. Just didn't get out of the way of it, and Dylan just way in tight on the pitch. Starting to be up now.
Fordham a chance to make some noise here with the bases loaded. Bill Champy, who has been the man of the hour for Fordham all afternoon. 1-for-3 in this second game, 4 hits in the first game.
So a single, a walk, and a hit pitch, and now you'd have to call this a huge at-bat for Bill Champy.
Look to the ball outside.
Again, being fine, he's throwing the slider there on the outside corner. The big successful thing that he was doing while he was getting all the hitters out was getting up on hitters.
Grounded foul down the third base side. One ball, one strike. He's thrown a lot of pitches here today. Even though he retired the last 10 in a row, he threw a ton of pitches in those first
early
three innings.
Yeah, he really did. I think if he can get through this inning, we're going to probably look to some relief. Difficult to see if anyone is warming up down in the main bullpen.
DeLuca on third, Ankalara on second, Montgomery on first. Two outs, one ball, one strike. The count to Bill Champy. Maine leading 5-2. We're in the top of the seventh.
Oh, what a break.
You betcha. One ball, two strikes.
Now, this is where, see if Dylan drops down with the slider now. That's his out pitch. He comes high and tight, and Champy just can't pull the trigger. The ball was up around his eye level. It's been a tough, tough out today, though.
The 1-2 pitch. Foul back, and the count stays the same. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Bases full of Fordhams.
Ready to round the bases if they can get a gap. Line drive by Champy here.
Just missed high, 2-2. I mean just missed.
I think we're gonna look back at this point in the game when it's over. Definitely critical juncture.
Champy fouls off another one.
Dylan is really getting up with these pitches.
Hey, 2-2 pitch from Dillon. Champy pops another one foul back over our head.
Good at bat here by Champy, really battling. Dillon battling right back.
Again, Dillon readies himself for the 2-2 delivery.
Shaking off what Ender is calling.
And again, Champy hangs tough. Who's the advantage go to in a long at bat like this?
Well, I think with a 2-2 count like this, it's difficult to say, Mike. I think the hitter. I think the longer you chip away like this, the pitcher, you know, you eventually might give in. But it's who can crack first, really, in this kind of situation.
There's a long drive deep to left field. It is out of here. A grand slam home run for Bill Champy.
Well, I guess Champy won that little contest. Amazing. Just amazing. Whoa, talk about huge. Bill Champy, what a day. A stunned crowd here at Mahaney.
First home run of the tournament for Bill Champy, and he couldn't have picked a better time. A tremendous shot.
And he just battled. It was a great at bat. It's a slider that just hangs right in the middle of the plate, Mike, and you can just forget about it. Put a charge into that ball over.
Over by the football stadium.
That's right. His teammates are just, boy, they have gone from reeling to the point now where they can taste it.
Bill Champy, what an afternoon.
Oh, four hits in the first game. A couple more here, but what do you have, four RBIs in the first game?
Yep.
He's got eight RBIs.
And again, it was Dillon was rolling along and put down 10 in a row, the clean single by DeLuca. And all of a sudden, he gave up a walk, hit a batter, and gives up a grand slam.
Well, it's... it's a fine line.
2-1, the count to Andy Apostle.
There's no doubt about that Dillon home run.
There was none.
Blocked it.
Dillon catches the outside corner. The count is 2-2. But the damage has been done here in the top of the seventh. Full count now, 3-2. Here's a shot by Apostle to center field, but room out there for Mark Sweeney, who puts it away. But Bill Champy, the big hit, a grand slam home run here in the seventh inning. And Fordham has taken the lead 6-5.
Sports Channel brings you the whole picture on horse racing with Rockingham Report. Every racing day, Rockingham Report gives you a complete look at the day's racing from Rockingham Park in New Hampshire. Each show is filled with the day's results and keeps you up to date on current standings and upcoming events at the track. But most important is our start-to-finish coverage of each race on the card, including simulcasts from other leading tracks across the country. So stay tuned in to the New England horse racing scene. Watch Rockingham Report every racing day on Sports Channel.
New England, a special place with majestic scenery, incredible wildlife, and some of the best fishing action seen anywhere in the world. Hi, I'm Don Sonny, and this year on Sports Channel, I'll be your host for New England Rod and Reel, New England's top outdoor program dedicated to bringing you the people, places, and fishing action that makes us all proud and fortunate to be part of this great country. Each week, we'll bring to you a different little piece of New England. So whether it's a battling bluefish off Nantucket or an acrobatic smallmouth in New Hampshire, be sure to tune in to New England Rod and Reel, only on Sports Channel.
The man of the hour for the Fordham Rams, Bill Champy, the grand slam home run. in the seventh to give Fordham a 6-5 lead in an afternoon full of long shots.
Well, he just battled Jim Dillon for his entire at bat.
Jim Dillon knew it.
He did. He looked up and said, oh no, can't be happening. I've been rolling in this game, and just sends a charge into it. Goodbye. Well, this is gut check time now for Maine.
Shannon Knox will lead it off. All of a sudden, the breaking balls of Bill Conkling are looking big.
Yeah, they really are. Dan Gallagher deep into his pitching staff. Freshman Conkling out there for the second time today. He's the pitcher of record now for Fordham. See if the top of the order for Maine can do something.
Whoa. A little over the head job by Conkling there, ball one.
Breaking ball that decided not to break.
But never did.
Just let that one go somewhere behind him. And just Shannon Knox with a good ducking effort.
One ball, one strike. Up to the right side. Santi Galone back, and he's got it. One down in the bottom of the seventh.
Tough day at the plate for Knox today. Did drive the ball very well his last time off.
Takes one outside, ball one.
Well, Maine needs some base runners. Fordham just some solid defense.
Missing with the breaking ball, 2-0. Ball three. Three balls, one strike, one out. Nobody on here, bottom of the seventh. Fordham off the Bill Champion Grand Slam, ahead by 1-6-5. Base hit, right field.
Sequin's a tough house.
And the tying run is now down at first.
Seguin just lays the bat on the ball, gets the fastball out over the plate. Just able to dump it in there over Santi Galone's head. And that's what Maine needs is a base runner. Mark Sweeney swinging the bat up there.
Side to Sweeney, ball one. Run, taking his time. Inside again, ball two. Action down in the Fordham bullpen.
I'll tell you, by the motion that I just saw, I can't read a number from here. It looked like Jay Hutchinson's motion. He threw three already, didn't he, in the first one? This is it, though.
Pulls foul down the first baseline. Count goes to 2-1. Pulled foul down the left field line. Conklin is back even at 2-2 with Sweeney.
The big thing with Conklin right now as a hitter facing him is to just be patient. He's being very deliberate on the mound. He's shaking his arm. He's probably stiff in the arm. He's throwing a lot of breaking balls. Just got to be patient in there and wait for it. Try to drive it.
Looks like Ray Hutchinson working again down the bullpen. Stop down there. Play is only at first base. DeLuca makes it.
Yeah, DeLuca just stands in there. He's been nailed by a couple of these ground balls. He just holds his ground. That's well done.
So two down here in the bottom of the seventh.
It's a hard hit ball, and DeLuca, presence of mind, to still look down to second base to see if he could beat Seguin to the bag, but decided to just take the sure out. And you can bet that Hartung is going to see a few breaking balls here from Conklin. There's one.
It's a strike in the outside corner.
I'd be looking for it right now if I was Hartung, and just try to jump on one of those that he might leave out over the plate.
Didn't see anything to hit the last time up off that home run. One strike pitch. Foul back, and he's in a two strike hole.
And I would have been looking for a curveball there, and I wouldn't be able to get around on that fastball. Right now, what Hartung needs, though, is a home run would be great, but right now for his ball club, if he can just find a hole out there somewhere, he can get Seguin home, tie this ball game up. Fordham has to be thinking right now that they're a team of destiny. I mean, they came out and really got the hits in the first game, and they just don't seem to die. Maine was in the driver's seat in the second game, but everyone was a little surprised, including me, when Champy took that ball out for the slam.
Hartung hanging in there.
That's a pretty good hook right there by Conklin.
One ball, two strikes, two outs. Seguin out at second base, representing the tying run. Ball gets by, and Seguin will go to third. Wild pitch.
That ball came up well short of home plate.
Count goes to 2-2.
Well, Secor does what he can to get out in front of that one and does deflect it, but unable to stop Seguin from getting over to third base.
And now the pitching coach will make his way out to the mound to have a word with Bill Conkling. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Seguin at third. Fordham ahead by a run.
He's telling him here, don't make, you know, too fat of a pitch with Hartung up there. The man on third base. Mike Brewerd out there, the pitching coach.
Come on. 2-2 pitch. Misses inside, and it goes full, 3-2. So a big point, not only in the ball game, but the season right now for the Black Bears of Maine.
That's right, they need one here to tie this game up.
And outside, ball four. And runners will now be at first and third. And Craig Ender will be the man on the spot.
Almost got hard tongue to bite for that one, but not quite.
You got to figure they weren't going to give hard tongue anything good to hit. Someone's going to beat you. It's not going to be Andy Hard Tongue.
Conkling wants it. At least check it over there at first base. There was a check and no call.
Ender, hard hit to short, but one hopper over to Galone. And Fordham's out of the inning, and they hold on to the lead. We have played seven at 6-5 Fordham.
What better way to follow America's favorite pastime than watching Sports Channel's baseball lineup? First up is Mets Inside Pitch. Fran Healy follows the Mets all season long and keeps you updated on the team's progress. On deck is the Pennant Chase. What better way is there to keep up with the boys of summer? And the ace of the staff is Ed Randall's Talking Baseball. Hear from the players who make baseball the great tradition that it is. So don't get caught off base. Get the whole baseball picture on Sports Channel. Sports Channel is the only place to get the whole soccer picture, and with football fever rising, you won't want to miss any of the action. Catch New England's own Boston Bolts as they compete in their third season of professional soccer action on Sports Channel. The U.S. national team prepares for World Cup competition as Sports Channel brings you exhibition matches against teams from around the world. And don't miss the best of the best on English League Soccer. Join us for the best soccer action found anywhere right here on Sports Channel.
Battle for hockey's most coveted prize continues tonight as game three of the Stanley Cup Finals shift out to Edmonton. This pivotal contest showcases the Boston Bruins and Edmonton Oilers on the Northland's ice. The face-off is set for 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific time, live on Sports Channel. This event not seen in all areas, so check your local listings for details. Stanley Cup Finals coming up later on tonight here on Sports Channel. Not much wind at all here at the Mahaney Diamond right now, and we head into the eighth inning with Fordham up 6-5, looking to make a miraculous comeback after losing their first game in this tournament. Dan Gallagher's club has really turned it around and have the lead as we head into the eighth inning.
And John Winken's gone to the bullpen again with Chuck Nado out there right now. He's pitched 13 innings this year. He's got an ERA of 7.44. He has not seen a lot of action, as both coaches now having to go very deep into the bullpens. And Conkling is doing an outstanding job for Fordham right now.
Sure is.
He's come in and he's held Maine down and allowed his team to swing the bats. And of course, Bill Champy took care of that with one fell long run. Job bringing in all four runs with the grand slam an inning ago.
Kevin Secor will lead it off here in the eighth inning. Chuck Nado looking to just hold the fort. Misses outside with his first delivery, ball one.
Chuck is from Bangor, Maine, so he's a hometown boy. Some arm injuries last year, only pitched an inning.
One and one. Drive out to left field, quite on his horse, and it'll fall in front of him. So Kevin Secor leads off the eighth with a single.
Secor's got that one down, doesn't he? Patented to drop into left.
Second hit of the afternoon for Kevin. Goes that way comfortably. I'll bring Sam Champy to the plate. You won't invite the Champy family back to Maine in a hurry. three hits in the first game.
Looks like we might have a pinch runner here for Secor.
Mike Scavetta.
Running for Secor, number 10, Mike Scavetta.
So Scavetta will run at first. Kevin Secor sits down. Good job behind the plate for 16 innings this afternoon. Guys doing wind sprints on the down the first baseline, drawing the ire of the crowd.
Supposed to have done that before you go out there is the idea.
All right, Sam Champy will step in and Chuck Nato looking for his first out. Inside, ball one.
Secor, got a pinch runner in for him out of the ball game. Bill Champy has actually done some backup catching for Fordham. We'll see what kind of move Dan Gallagher makes.
Bunt put down. They're going to go to second, and they got him at second. Nice play by Nadal.
That's a good aggressive play. He went right at it, wheeled, and just didn't hesitate.
Another look, no doubt where Chuck was going to go as soon as he got this. Just throw.
That's a good play.
Jim McDermott up. Two for three in the nightcap. Pitch from Nadal. This is low ball two. Champy over at first. Scavetta, the pinch runner, taken out on the force. McDermott, little dribbler back to the mound. Again, Nadal winds up for second, and he got him again.
Ooh.
That one was a lot closer.
That sure was. This time, I don't know. I'm not sure he should have gone this way with it, but he, Nato turns around and winds up and throws. That's a very close play at second base. Let's see if he really gets him here. Low throw.
Well,
tough to tell from that angle.
Tough to tell. I like that.
A lot of dirt flying up in there. Tell you what, it's been a well officiated today. The umps have done a good job. There have been some bang bang plays.
Santi Galone at the plate, two down, runner still on first. Now it's McDermott. Third different man to lead off first base in this inning. Pops that one up. No room behind the plate. Ender making the bid. One strike to Galone, two down, runner on first, 6-5 Fordham, we're in the eighth.
Galone has got some power himself on the season. He was able to hit six home runs. Tied for team lead with Bill Champy, who, of course, got number seven, the big slam just an inning ago.
Looks at one low, one and one.� Drive down the right field line, foul. Count will hold at 1-2. Steps back in.
Nice
just missed.
Nice piece of catching there, too, by Ender. Called that framing the ball, and he really did a nice job to cup it. It was very close. When you cup it like that, it makes the ball look like it's coming a little higher than it has, perhaps.
Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Runner at first, 6-5 Fordham, are in the top of the eighth. Galone hits a shot to center field, deep. Sweeney on his horse, and he's got room.
Put a charge into it. A lot of room out there.
We have played 7.5 at 6-5 Fordham.
Sports Channel dazzles you with the latest in thoroughbred action nationwide on Inside Racing. Join Harvey Pack for the weekend review, plus helpful hints on what's ahead. Inside Racing. Sports Channel is the authority on thoroughbred horse racing. Wednesday through Monday, Thoroughbred Action presents exclusive coverage from the major New York State tracks. Chart all the races here first on Thoroughbred Action.
Sports Channel is the only place to get the whole soccer picture, and with football fever rising, you won't want to miss any of the action. Catch New England's own Boston Bolts as they compete in their third season of professional soccer action on Sports Channel. The U.S. national team prepares for World Cup competition as Sports Channel brings you exhibition matches against teams from around the world. And don't miss the best of the best on English League Soccer. Join us for the best soccer action found anywhere right here on Sports Channel.
Coming down to crunch time here for the Black Bears of the University of Maine, down 1-6-5 as we head into the bottom of the eighth inning. Mike Scavetta has gone to left field. He came in to pinch run, and Bill Champy, who's been doing a little bit of everything for this club, including hitting grand slams, has moved behind the plate.
Conkling has done a great job, though, in relief. He's a little shaky at first, throwing a lot of breaking balls, but he's found himself a groove, and kept the Maine Bears quiet.
Tim Scott's gonna lead it off here, the second baseman. Hit by a pitch in the second inning, grounded into a 4-6-3 double play in the fourth, and popped out to the first baseman in the sixth.
This is it, Mike. Come down to two at bats for Maine. Down by a run. Winner advances.
Bill Champy fixing up some equipment. Now he makes his way out.
Day he's had, he's entitled to.
Yeah. All right, Bill Conkling set to go, and again the fans of the Black Bears trying to make a little noise, but Conkling starts it off with a strike on Scott. Side 1-1. Hey. He is throwing. He's going to soak that arm tonight because he's throwing 90% breaking balls out there, isn't he?
He really is. Gutty effort on his part.
One ball, two strikes. The ground ball right back up the middle. Conkling the underhanded toss. One down, bottom of the eighth.
The way to do it, I guess. Get a little few steps over there and then scoop it.
Gary Taylor steps to the plate.
Maine badly needs a base runner. Scott hangs in pretty good here. Another half a foot, and he's got himself a tough play over the middle. But Conkling right there with the scoop toss. Taylor has swung the bat well today with the most notable, the long home run. Right now, though, with John Winken need more than anything is just to get someone on base. Try to create something.
Changed up on him, 1-1. John Winken working the sideline.
I'll say. He knows it's crunch time.
Misses outside, 2-1. Can't throw those straight pitches, Bill.
Come back to the curve.
Hutchinson still throwing down the bullpen.
Like a changeup.
Count is full of 3-2. One down, nobody on, bottom of the eighth. Fordham leads 6-5.
Curveball, Mike.
This is outside. And the tying run trots down to first. It's the fourth walk of the day to Gary Taylor, who is a patient hitter.
He really is. It's a good cut up there, or else he watches it very closely, a sign of a good hitter.
Mike DeLucia struck out his last time up. 0-for-3 in the nightcap. Here's the hook for a strike.
DeLucia's due for a hit for Maine.
One ball, one strike. Missing low, 2-1. To short. McDermott over to second and it's dropped over there. Whoa. Now the call is out.
Well, the one thing Taylor should do in that situation is stay on the base. It looks like they're going to call an out.
The call was initially made as safe. I thought he had dropped it. Let's take a look.
McDermott really zings it in there. Just slide. I'll tell you what, it doesn't look like he had possession of the ball. Now what the call might be that as he went to pull it out of the glove to throw the ball that he lost control of it.
That would have to be.
I'll tell you, if he did have it, it wasn't for very long, Mike.
John Winken didn't stay too long.
I'll tell you, it doesn't look like he had it. Looks like he just dropped it.
And the ump originally said he was safe, and then changed the call to out. But he is out, and there's two down, a runner on first.
Now, the ruling clearly there that he lost it on the way out of the glove, but it was just so split second, he just didn't have it.
So Chad White comes up with two outs and a runner on first.
Split second calls, we're catching a piece of it there. Clearly was trying to get it out to throw it, but just didn't look like he had it for that long if he had it.
Chad White loops one out in the right field, but room and time for Sam Champy, and we'll head to the ninth inning, 6-5, Fordham.
If you're a fan of the SEC, then you'll want to join us each week on SEC Weekly. I'm Gail Searins, and I host the only sports magazine show that looks at a conference from football to basketball season, from baseball to tennis season. We keep you up to date with all of the happenings in the SEC for both men's and women's sports. So join me each week right here on Sports Channel for SEC Weekly.
What better way to follow America's favorite pastime than watching Sports Channel's baseball lineup? First up is Mets Inside Pitch. Grant Healy follows the Mets all season long and keeps you updated on the team's progress. On deck is the Pennant Chase. What better way is there to keep up with the boys of summer? And the ace of the staff is Ed Randall's Talking Baseball. Hear from the players who make baseball the great tradition that it is. So don't get caught off base. Get the whole baseball picture on Sports Channel.
We are back here at Mahaney Diamond, headed into the ninth inning, and Fordham off that grand slam in the seventh by Bill Champy has a 6-5 lead. It appeared the Black Bears of Maine had control of this game as Jim Dillon, the previous pitcher, was rolling along, having retired 10 in a row, then a single, a walk, a hit batsman, and a grand slam home run. Happened very quickly, and the roof fell in. Now it's up to Chuck Nato to once again hold the fort here in the top of the ninth and give Maine a chance to come up down just one.
Well, you just have a feeling the way the ball we've seen today that some interesting things will happen in this last inning. I just don't think everything will go down quietly here in the ninth. But clearly that's Chuck Nato's job right now, is to get the 2-3-4 hitters of Fordham to sit back down so that Maine can go in and swing.
Peter DeLuca pops one back overhead. No balls, one strike. Outside corner, 0-2. Two as Nadal misses outside. Even at two.
DeLuca really was the one who got to Dillon with that line single, and then as you had mentioned, the roof kind of caved in after that. Solid hit to center.
Wait, count goes full of 3-2. Lost him, and DeLuca gets a walk to lead off the night.
Good at bat by DeLuca. Really worked Nadeau that time.
Action in the bullpen for the University of Maine. Bunt and beauty down there. Knox will make the quick play, but a good sacrifice gets DeLuca out to second base.
Nice coverage first by Scott. Dan Gallagher trying right now to see if he can get himself an insurance run.
One down to Ray Montgomery.
Beautiful bunt here. Hank Villari gets it down. Gets the job done.
DeLuca on second, representing an insurance run here for the Rams of Fordham.
Gonna put him on, Mike.
Some of the fans here are not happy with John Winken's decision to put Montgomery on, but it sets up the force.
I think it's a good move, and that way he still gives himself a chance for a double play.
The thing is, it brings Bill Champy to the plate.
That is a problem.
So Montgomery makes his way down to first, runners at first and second now, one out, top of the ninth. And the young man who wouldn't lose a draw should get a hero's welcome when he returns to Fordham, Bill Champy.
He's done more than his part today. He's been outstanding with the bat. Versatile too, left field, catcher.
Eight RBIs on the afternoon.
He's had a fantastic day today at the plate.
John Winken putting the pressure on his pitcher now to deal with Champy. Misses high, ball one. Side 2-0.
Well, Champy is just so confident up there right now. In a groove.
Must be a great feeling to be on a roll like that.
In a groove. Kind of grooves only come around every once in a while. He should be enjoying what he's going through today.
2-1.
Nadal throwing the ball at pretty good velocity.
This is inside, and the count goes to 3-1. One down, two on for Fordham, leading 6-5 in the ninth. There's a long drive, a titanic drive that's going foul.
Wow.
And it's 3-2. That's a long strike, that's all it is. Someone yells in the main dugout, but it was indeed a long strike.
And you know, when you're pitching, you get to see that long strike go out way over the fence, even though it's foul, and you say, whoa.
The 3-2 pitch. Champy fouls that one back off the left side.
Started getting into one of these things with Dillon with these foul balls.
I was just going to say, he's not an easy out, is he?
Until he finally got one that he could put a charge into.
The 3-2 pitch. This is outside, ball four, and the bases are loaded. John Winken is going to take a trip to the mound.
And he's looking down to the bullpen.
And that'll be it for Chuck Nadeau. We're going to take a little break here. It's 6-5 in the ninth.
This is professional wrestling's ultimate challenge. Teams of wrestling's best athletes battle each other in hopes of winning the sport's newest treasure. But they must first conquer its most unique matches. The American Wrestling Association presents All-Star Wrestling and the Team Challenge Series.
Today, Sports Channel dazzles you with the latest in thoroughbred action nationwide on Inside Racing. Join Harvey Pack for the weekend review, plus helpful hints on what's ahead. Inside Racing. Sports Channel is the authority on thoroughbred horse racing. Wednesday through Monday, Thoroughbred Action presents exclusive coverage from the major New York State tracks. Start all the races here first on Thoroughbred Action.
We're back, and the battle for hockey's most coveted prize continues tonight as Game 3 of the Stanley Cup Final shifts to Edmonton. This pivotal contest showcases the Boston Bruins and the Edmonton Oilers on the Northland's ice. The face-off tonight is set for 8 p.m. Eastern Time, not too far away, 5 p.m. Pacific, live on Sports Channel. This event not seen in all areas, so check your local listings for details. Mike D'Andrea has now come on to pitch. He comes in with the bases loaded and one out, trying to hold the fort so Maine can have a shot in the bottom of the ninth.
10-3 in the season, and he's the ace of the staff. And John Winken clearly knows that he has to shut the door right here against Fordham so that the Black Bears can come in and give it a shot to make a final comeback in the bottom of the ninth. So this is everything on the line time right now for Maine.
Dan Gallagher having a few words with Andy Apostle, who'll step to the plate. Quickly ahead of the count, 0-1. DeLuca down at third, Montgomery at second, Champy at first. The 0-1 pitch, ground ball, knocked, straight play down at third. Comes home for one.
Heck of a play. Heck of a play right there by Knox. Maine had to have it.
Shannon Knox throwing some leather.
There's such a huge difference between trailing by a run in the ninth or having to come in knowing you've got to get two to tie and three to win. That's a big play.
So Mike Scavetta, who came in as a pinch runner with Kevin Secor a couple of innings back, now we'll get his first at bat. DeAndre looking to get the Black Bears out of a jam. Missing low, ball one.
Scavetta did a very nice job this year with limited playing time, batting 537.
Right up the middle. Play at second, easy one made by Tim Scott. And the Black Bears of Maine get out of a jam, but they are still down one. We head to the bottom of the ninth, 6-5 Fordham.
Season, tune in to Sports Channel for New England's top outdoor program, New England Rod and Reel. Hi, I'm Don Sonny, your host, and I'll be introducing you to some of the finest game fishing seen anywhere. We'll travel throughout the scenic inland and offshore waters in New England to bring you fishing action at its best. From trout to tuna, bass to bluefish, you'll find it all on New England Rod and Reel. The latest tackle, hints from the pros, and always the scenery and wildlife that makes New England so unique. So join us each week for New England Rod and Reel, only on Sports Channel.
It is last call for the Black Bears of the University of Maine. They're faithful on their feet as we head to the bottom of the ninth. Fordham with the 6-5 lead. Bill Conkling, who has done an outstanding job in relief, stays on the mound. Maine will have the top of the order, Knox, Seguin, and Sweeney. Conkling bounces in his final warm-up toss. They're a little tight, maybe, but he has pitched very well.
He sure has. Done a fantastic job in relief. The fourth of the Fordham pitchers today. But Lehman and Biggins were very short stints after LeJudas went the first four innings.
Everybody but the outfielders huddled around Bill Conkling on the mound.
Saying, this is it, guys.
Right.
Three more.
Three and we're out of here.
Maine, on the other hand, needs a base runner. And it's top of the order time. Shannon Knox has got to find a way to get on base. Playing him in at third.
Knox with that great defensive play in the top of the inning to save a run. Here we go, bottom of the ninth. Conklin high with the curveball.
There's something about the ninth inning, too. No matter what kind of slump you've been in, the fans get into it. It's always an interesting finale to things. More pressure.
One ball, one strike. These are the moments you imagine as a kid if you're Bill Conklin.
That's it.
The 1-1 pitch. Knox pops it up right side. Champion right field. One down. Ryan Seguin comes to the plate. Seguin 1-for-4 on the afternoon in the second game. It was 1-for-4 in the first game.
Maine just has not been able to solve Conkling in this second game.
Keeps throwing the hooks up there. He's at a variety of speeds.
He's jump balling it, and Maine is being patient in some cases and getting walked, but they're not getting real good hacks at these balls.
Misses inside, ball two. 2-0. One down, bottom of the ninth. Maine trailing by one. ECAC Division I Baseball Championship at stake. Out to center field on his horse, Ray Montgomery. Plenty of room. Two down.
One out away.
Two fly ball outs. And it comes down to Mark Sweeney, who had a home run in the first inning of this game. Doubled in the fourth. Has flied out and grounded out since then. Maine down to their final out. And for Fordham, who came up here and lost the opening game of this tournament, a remarkable comeback.
If they can pull this off, this would be their fifth win.
And Dan Gallagher is going to take a trip to the mound. And he'll be joined by most of his team.
The question is whether he's going to bring Hutchinson in or not. Yep, there it is.
So the change will be made. Bill Conkling, a great job in relief.
Well, his teammates letting him know that right on the mound, too. A couple of the guys went over and shook his hand. They're bringing in not Hutchinson, but Mr. Elmer.
Started things off about 7.5 hours ago, didn't he?
His arm's going to be hanging right now. He threw five in the first game, but it's come on in and get me an out. Face a batter.
And Bill Conkling will get a hand from the Maine baseball fans. You said they appreciate good baseball, and they know the job this kid has done.
A lot of poise for a freshman, too. He's pitched in this game like he's a seasoned veteran, just an outstanding effort. Shut Maine down, gave his team a chance to score some runs, and Bill Champy took care of that with a grand slam in the seventh.
Again, that is not Jay Hutchinson, it is Bob Elmer who has come in. Hutchinson was warming up with Elmer, but it'll be Bob Elmer, who takes the mound. Elmer started the first game, pitched very well for five innings. Left at about 2:30 this afternoon, and he's back at about 7:35 tonight to try to ice it for the Rams of Fordham.
This is the role he's been accustomed to all year. But a gutty performance in the first game today. He went five, ran out of gas in the sixth. I'd have to say his arm right now be a little bit tired, but to come in and get an out and seal the ECAC championship, these are special days and special games.
So here we go. It'll be Mark Sweeney stepping in against Bob Elmer. Two down, bottom of the ninth. Fordham leads 6-5. Nobody on. Sweeney, a home run and a double in four at bats. And it's the nightcap.
He's been
a long day of baseball here at Orno, Maine.
He's been swinging the ball, the bat, extremely well, too, for Maine. That's why Dan Gallagher figured, hey, I'm going to bring in my ace closer against Mark Sweeney.
Here we go. Little ground ball down first, should be handled.
Off his foot, Mike.
A break for the Black Bears.
Tell the way that ball squibbed out there. It came off the foot and just went flat. Oh yeah, there it is, right off the shin bone.
Taking his time getting to the mound. Sweeney now steps in. No balls, one strike. Here's the pitch. Missing outside, 1-1.
That's Almer's pitch right there, the curveball. Tough on the lefty. Sweeney's just got to try to hit it hard somewhere. Find an opening.
1-1 pitch. Sweeney gets that at top.
Well hit.
To right center field. It's tied at six.
Oh, the hanging curve. Forget it.
Mark Sweeney, his second home run of the afternoon, ties it at six in the bottom of the ninth. With two outs, a 1-1 pitch, and he got all of it.
Talk about delivering, Mike, at the right time. Hanging curve. See you later. Check this out. Oh, did Sweeney mash that ball? Second one of the game.
Well out of here.
He's enjoying it, and he should. Two out in the ninth. Unbelievable.
Dan Gallagher has to be thinking about the pitching change.
You know it. And Bob Almer probably can't go too much further. In his arm, he came in basically to get a batter. I look for him to come out and maybe bring Hutchinson in.
Gonna throw one anyway to Hartung. And Hartung rips a single to left field. Bill Champy, the catcher, looking over at the Fordham dugout.
As if to say, can you believe this?
Doesn't appear to be anybody throwing in the bullpen for Fordham. And Craig Ender up now with the winning run at first base. Two down, ninth inning, tied at six. Dramatically on the Mark Sweeney home run. Ender fouls one off down the third baseline.
Conkling had been rolling along. You go with the percentages, and you bring in the lefty. And that's probably what Dan Gallagher's been doing all year long, and it just, Mark Sweeney just caught up with that ball.
Inside, gets away from the catcher, and suddenly now, Andy Hartung in scoring position out at second base.
Ball just digs down. Champy tries to block it, gets a piece, but enough time for Hartung to get down in scoring position.
Well, Hartung now at second. The count 1-1 to Craig Ender. Ender 1-for-3 and a walk on the afternoon. And Dan Gallagher will make another trip to the mound. That's a great look. And it appears he's going to make another pitching change. This time it looks like it will be Hutchinson coming back in. And a quick reminder here, strap yourself in for high-speed excitement as Sports Channel takes you trackside for a recap of the week in motorsports. Speedway Sunday puts racing fans on the inside track for worldwide auto racing action. Beginning June 3rd, look to Speedway Sunday every week at 7:30 p.m. Eastern, 4:30 p.m. Pacific, right here on Sports Channel. Check your local listings for availability in your area. Bob Almer heads for the dugout. And it'll be up to Jay Hutchinson here to get the final out and try to send this one into extra innings. Hutchinson pitched effectively in the first game. The Black Bears of Maine refused to go easily. Mark Sweeney, the hero, his second home run of the game with two outs in the ninth inning to tie it at six. Then Hartung a walk. A wild pitch gets him over to second, and all of a sudden Fordham sitting pretty, one out away from an ECAC championship. Now needs Hutchinson to slam the door here and get them into extra innings.
And both balls that Sweeney has hit out today have been blasts.
Hutchinson completing his warm-up tosses. Ender standing about 2 or 3 feet outside your picture, checking him out. Ender is set to go with two out in the ninth inning here. One ball and one strike, the count to Craig Ender.
Well, it's a game of inches. Maine had to get out of a bases loaded one out jam in the ninth inning with Fordham up, and a nice stop at third base by Shannon Knox keeps the thing at a one run game. And now Maine in a position with a base hit to win this game themselves.
Ender steps in. Hutchinson looks in for the sign. The 1-1 pitch misses outside, 2-1. Hartung, the walking lead off second. No one is holding him. He's got a good jump. Ender, foul down the first base side. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Hartung on second base. Hutchinson looks in. Gets the sign. The pitch. Fouled off again. Oof,
just got a piece of that ball. Hartung's getting a fantastic jump off of second base.
Who's going to score on anything resembling a hit here?
The outfield also is pretty deep. It's also somewhat surprising. Really got to cheat in this situation, and anything over your head, it doesn't matter.
The 2-2 pitch to Ender. Hangs tough.
exactly. This was the gamble that Dan Gallagher took today by throwing his two ace stoppers in the first game. Almer and Hutchinson have already pitched quite a few innings today.
The 2-2 pitch. Struck him out. We will go to extra innings to decide the ECAC baseball championships. Hutchinson comes in and gets Ender. We're tied at 6 after 9. Decide the ECAC baseball championships here. A dramatic home run by Mark Sweeney in the bottom of the ninth has tied this game at 6. Sam Champy will lead it off. Here's a look at Mark Sweeney with that big blast. Home run in the first inning, home run in the ninth inning.
And sandwich one off the bottom of the fence in between for a double, but this was the home run that tied it up. A blast to the left of the 375 sign. That's Ray Montgomery. All he can do is watch. It's well over the fence. And that ties the ball game up, and Mark Sweeney elated, crossing the plate, his teammates crowd around him.
So Sam Champy will lead it off here as Sweeney gets himself set in the outfield. DeAndrea misses outside, ball one.
Well, fortunate for John Winken that he saved his ace to pitch at the end of the ball game. Thought it was just to come in and put out a fire at the end of the last inning, and now a chance to keep him hurling, to hold Fordham down, to give the Maine bats another chance.
Here's a shot to left field, but they're making the catch, Chad White.
When things like that happen, you start to sense another momentum shift in this ballgame. It's been amazing
today.
There
have been many.
Right on the nose, fastball down the pipe, Sam Champy all over it. But hangs up there long enough for Chad White, and a nice little slide. Made sure of it.
Strike, the count to McDermott. One and two.
DeAndrea brought those last two in with some velocity.
Drive up the middle, base hit for Jim McDermott.
It's a good piece of hitting by McDermott.
McDermott right on top of that pitch. Brings Santi Galone to the plate. One on, one out, top of the 10th. Galone, little dribbler down the third base line. Knox is there, got him at first.
Knox has been very solid defensively.
Sure has.
Fordham, though, with a man on second base and a chance to put a run across. It's a breaking ball that just gets topped by Santi Galone and knocks again there. Feet get tangled up between DeLucia. Santi Galone right there on the inside of the bag. Fortunately, everyone seems to be okay on that play. That can be, you can get some serious foot injuries when your feet get tangled up and spiked on the way by the bag.
John Winken out to talk to DeAndrea as DeLuca has hit the ball solid all day long here.
John Winken with a very brief message out there. Probably something to the effect of go after him, but if he's going to beat you, make sure he beats you with your best stuff, and that's heat, keep it away from the plate.
Missing outside, ball one.
One and one. Keeping it on the outside corner. That's the way that Maine has been pitching Anquilari today. DeLuca has been on the ball.
Two and one.
Yeah, both of these teams have tough lineups, top to bottom.
DeLuca is shot into center field, a base hit. That's going to bring a run around to score. And Fordham retakes the lead. And DeLuca gets into second base.
Big
and
hit.
Again, a momentum shift.
Amazing.
Beat DeLuca, a rocket single to center field. Brings around Jim McDermott.
Been right on the nose all day hitting the baseball. Again, people might say, do you put him on and then pitch to Anquilari? And he's a tough hitter, too. And right behind him, Ray Montgomery. That ball was up, though, by DeAndrea. He'd been staying away from the plate.
Anquilari dribbles one foul down the third baseline as McDermott, a happy camper, coming across home plate.
Keep putting the pressure on.
Pitch to Anquilari. Change up. Misses high. 1-1. Maine with the early 4-1 lead in this game and the grand slam home run by Champy. One ball, two strikes now to Anquilari. A dramatic home run by Sweeney in the bottom of the ninth to take the lead. And Pete DeLuca now, the RBI single in the top of the 10th to give it back to Fordham. Two balls, two strikes. Two outs, DeLuca on second base. 7-6 Fordham, top of the 10th inning.
Another big run sitting out there for Fordham if they can bring it in.
Count is full. Anquilari rips one out in the gap in left center field. That is deep to the fence and goal!
My!
Mike Anquilari.
Unbelievable. I knew it was in the gap, but that ball just kept carrying.
A shot to left center field. And it's 9-6 Fordham.
Oh, amazing. Fordham come back and answered.
Wow.
This Fordham club is just hitting the baseball.
They really are swinging it, just roped by Anka Larry, and you could tell right away it's just going to be a ball in the gap, but all of a sudden Mark Sweeney says, whoa, has run out of room, and another blast to the gap. What a finish to this game.
Ray Montgomery steps in as some of the Maine faithful now start to head for the exits, believing they are no comebacks left.
Well, this will be a tough one, certainly. Three runs.
Two strikes to Montgomery.
I don't know about you, but I refuse to commit until we see it happen. That ball left the bat. The other balls today I thought were out. That one left the bat. I said that one's in the gap. But to see that sail over the fence, that just carried very well.
Montgomery rips one to left field, but White is there and takes it. But the damage is done. Three runs in for Fordham in the top of the 10th. They lead 9-6.
A special Pontiac offer. Limited to New England and select eastern states. Full 48-month 4.8 APR GMAC financing. Not just on one or two cars, but on 17 different models, including all new Grand Ams, Le Mans, Sunbirds, and Grand Prix. And here's a special option for Grand Prix and Grand Am buyers. 4.8 GMAC financing or $2,000 cash back. $2,000 cash back. See your New England.
Ever wonder what's back there? What's really back there? Nevlin products can organize your equipment so there is never a surprise. With roof racks, shelving, partitions, and accessories for all your needs. Thanks, Nevlin. Ever feel you could be more efficient? Wonder how? Nevlin products, providing cost-effective ways to organize your business in today's hurry-up workplace. Thanks, Nevlin. Nevlin, the rack people. Call 1-800-JOB-RACK for a distributor near you.
We are back to the bottom of the 10th inning. The Maine Black Bears responded once on a Mark Sweeney home run to tie up in the bottom of the 9th. They will try again. This time, though, they're down 3. Jay Hutchinson looking to get his club into the NCAA's, win an ECAC baseball championship. They are 3 outs away and 3 runs ahead. Gene hits for Fordham. My memory serves me correctly. That gives them 29 hits this afternoon.
To go with 20 yesterday against
Mike Ancolari on the top step, the designated hitter, doing his job.
Oh, I tell you, that was an enormous hit that he just had, a two-run job to give.
He's still stunned.
He is. 20 hits yesterday against New York Tech, so that's 49, Mike, combined. Now let's see what Maine can do.
Right.
See if they can bounce back, couple of runners on.
Tim Scott leading it off. And Hutchinson immediately ahead, 0-2.
Hutchinson's still throwing the ball pretty well. Through this afternoon, he's got the routine going now. He's back behind there on the grass. He thinks over every pitch, and then he gets in there and just steams it up there.
Just missed outside. 1-2. foul down the left field side. Count stays at 1-2. Side. Nice play by DeLuca.
Excellent play by DeLuca. He's made a couple of fine ones. Generally, you're protecting the lines, playing close, although you're surprised to see the righty go down the right field line with it. But he really has to make a tough stab here. Pete DeLuca came to play today. Solid at the plate and the field.
Fordham was within one out of winning this about 20 minutes ago. To Mark Sweeney, hit that home run. Hutchinson, though, throwing strikes again ahead on the count 0-1 here to Gary Taylor. Misses outside 1-1.
It over.
Yeah, I was just about to say that Hutchinson was a little pumped and working quickly, but as soon as he threw two balls in a row, he took a walk off the mound again. Misses outside ball three. Three balls, one strike. One out, nobody on. Bottom of the 10th, 9-6 Fordham. Maine in dire need of base runners.
Good job.
That is his third walk of the game.
Hit two in the first game.
Yep.
And he mixed in a home run in between.
It's all or nothing with Gary. He either hits it out or doesn't hit it. Gets on base though. So Mike DeLuca now up with a man on. Taylor holds it first. The 1-0 pitch. Drive foul down the right field side.
That's a tough pitch. Hutchinson comes across his body and just nails that outside corner. He's getting back in his groove right now. He's got that circle going around the mound.
One, two pitch. 2-2.
Thank you.
goes full 3-2. Nothing's coming easy in this game.
Not at all. Another ball here. Two men on. A couple of base hits. You just never know. Chad White on deck.
3-2 pitch. Drive foul down the right side. DeLucia hanging tough. Delivery. Drive into right field. Champy comes on and gets it. Makes a throw to first. Taylor gets back. Two down. Bottom of the 10th.
Well,
Maine again. Down to their final out. So it comes down to Chad White. He needs to get on base. Maine down 3.
Even if Maine is able to pull off some kind of a miraculous finish here, Mike, with two outs, if you look at the numbers that Fordham posted up on the board again, 9 runs, 13 hits, 16 hits in the first game, they really outplayed Maine today.
No question.
They've come out, they've swung the bats, they've got the timely hits. This was a game that looked like Maine had well under control, but forget it, they just keep coming at you.
Foul ball, right side. 0-1 to Chad White.
Certain teams just get hot at this time of year, and Fordham right now is on a mission.
We talked about the possibility of both of these teams seeing postseason action. Even if there was a miracle rally by Maine here, you would think Fordham would have to get some sort of nod off their performance this week.
Right. I think Maine has got an excellent shot the way this thing works. If you know, Fordham will get the automatic, I think Maine, you're going to think you'll have to get very serious consideration for the at-large bid. 40-plus victories.
One ball, one strike.
Hutchinson wanted it. Little Champy held it there for a couple extra seconds. Gutty effort by this kid. Throws a couple innings first game, back at it here in the nightcap.
1-1 pitch. Strike two. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Runner at first. Fordham ahead 9-6, bottom of the 10th. One out, one strike.
Hutchinson's gonna rear back right here.
Away from an ECAC baseball championship. Here it is. Drive into right field. Champy won't get it. It's over his head. Goes all the way to the wall. Champy tracks it down, makes the relay. Taylor will score from first. It is 9-7 with a runner on second base. And the tying run will come to the plate.
Unbelievable. Nice stroke by White. He just got on that ball and drove it. And then he didn't risk going to third on this play. Just got out the ball over the plate. Sends it over Sam Champy's head, well over it.
And Shannon Knox will step to the plate with a runner on second. He represents the tying run here in the bottom of the 10th.
No quit in either of these teams. They just keep battling back.
Knox 1-for-5 here in the nightcap.
Maine keeps swinging the bats themselves.
Foul ball off to the first base side. 0-1 the count on Knox. Nine, 13 and 0 for Fordham, 7, 10 and 1 for Maine. Hutchinson looks in. The 0-1 pitch.
Blew that right by him.
Sure did. 0-2. Knox in a big hole.
Knox has just got to think about contact up there. Anything close.
He's choked up.
Get the bat on the ball. Anything close.
The 0-2 pitch from Hutchinson. Outside, 1-2. Shannon Knox has made some great plays in the field this afternoon. Shakes off a sign of two. Oh, they go through the rotation again.
Been throwing almost exclusively fastballs during this stretch.
And now Champy's going to go out and talk to him. One ball, two strikes, two outs, 9-7 Fordham. Knox representing the tying run at the plate.
Been a terrific matchup today. Both teams have really been on the attack.
Hutchinson looks in. Here it comes. Ground ball down to second. Cologne scoops it up. Over to first. Fordham has won the ECAC Baseball Championship.
And they are mauling each other out on the field.
The Fordham Rams. A remarkable comeback after losing the first game of this double elimination tournament. Seeing a lead disappear in the bottom of the ninth inning, coming back with three runs in the top of the 10th. Getting their coach Dan Gallagher off a big hook when he made that pitching change. And the Fordham Rams have captured the 1990 ECAC Baseball Championship. We'll be back to wrap it up in just a second.
Part of the celebration and a part of the game. It's a big night out and a warm welcome home. When the job's well done and you call it a day, it's there. And for 80 million responsible Americans, it's simply a good part of a good life. It's beer.
Catch the excitement of professional outdoor soccer action with the Boston Bolts of the American Professional Soccer League. Don't miss the Bolts as they host the Orlando Lions on Saturday, May 26th, beginning at 7 p.m. from Boston University's Nickerson Field. Order your tickets now by calling 617-237-7373. Catch the soccer fever with the Boston Bolts.
Final score here. At the Mahaney Diamond on the campus of the University of Maine, the Fordham Rams with a doubleheader win today and a great performance. They win at 9-7 and they will advance to the NCAA tournament. And again, the ECAC couldn't have a hotter team going into that tournament right now than what Fordham showed this weekend. 15 runs to get to today's final action, and then 15 runs again in the first game today, and they finished off with 9 in the nightcap.
They were swinging the bats. Dan Gallagher wasn't kidding when he said, "I hope we can get the hitting going." And they sure put it together in the last three games of the tournament.
Okay, let's take a look at the big hit that came in the 10th inning after Mark Sweeney had dramatically tied the game in the bottom of the ninth. It was Mike Ancalaro with this opposite field job, and he got all of it. Out there by the 375 mark, looked like it was going to be a gapper. It just kept carrying, as Ron pointed out. And again, the Fordham Rams, just a great performance by Dan Gallagher and his club.
Yeah, they just swung. They wouldn't say die. Bill Champy with a huge hit today, because at that point, Maine was really in charge of the game. And when he hits that home run, he puts Fordham up by a run. And all of a sudden, it was just a complete shift in the momentum in the game, but neither team would say die right down to the finish.
Yeah, an excellent day of baseball here, and so the Fordham Rams are the 1990 ECAC Division I baseball champions. Thanks for joining us here on this long afternoon. I'm Mike Gorman, along with Ron Perry, saying goodbye from Orono, Maine. And coming up next, World Cup soccer. We'll be joining it in progress.
Double cash back. That's right. Come in now, make your best deal on a new 1990 Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme and get up to $2,000 cash back. Plus another $600 if you're a qualified first-time buyer. Up to $2,600, double cash back. Hey, they don't call us good old guys for nothing.
See the new generation at your good old guys.
To my beautiful wife.
It's nice to know he still loves the way you look. And if you wear dentures, you can count on Effordent to freshen up dentures and clean away stains so well. With Effordent, all he'll notice is you.
Hey! You don't want a meal on wheels! You want the whole kit and caboodle. It's got shapes, flavors, stuffing. Woo.
Kit and Caboodle brand cat food makes other meals seem downright mousy.
Oh, cats.
Honey, how much I loved you till you went away.
Have you seen my cat?
I'd give up everything I own to have you back today. I miss you, you're my only friend. If I could hear your voice again.
Warren!
I'll gladly give you Nana.
You're found.
I didn't know I was lost.
All right, thrill seekers, listen up. You're going to like this next story. A new sporting event tailor-made for the daring, and it premiered in Atlanta today. The event, indoor bungee jumping. Oh, dear. Well, this is the first ever indoor bungee jump. Each contestant plunges 14 stories and is then yanked to safety at the last moment by an elastic cord. Yanked to safety, I guess he hopes. Looks like a lot of fun, right, Rich?
Couldn't pay me to go out there.
That's incredible.
Our favorite sportscaster, clad in suspenders, is under the weather tonight, so Jennifer and I will have the sports for you. We will start with the hoops. First, we go to the Big East Wars. Connecticut ran away from Seton Hall in a game seen here on Channel 9. The league-leading Huskies ran off the first 11 points of the game. Chris Smith finished this break. And UConn broke the Pirates. And Lou Carnesecca knew something was fishy at the Garden as DePaul led St. John's by 10 at the half. But Robert Worden sparked a rally. He had 20 points, 15 rebounds, and two big foul shots at the end. St. John's beat DePaul 77-74.
Well, in another Big East encounter, Villanova coach Raleigh Massimino got plenty of indigestion, most of it coming from Georgetown big man Dikembe Mutombo. He jammed in 22 points, grabbed 18 rebounds, and fifth-ranked Georgetown crushed Villanova 83-53. Well, out in Las Vegas, they know how to warm up the crowd and pay tribute to their coach, Tark the Shark. But Jerry Tarkanian didn't have to chew up too many towels today. Here, Stacey Ogman rises to the occasion against Louisville's Felton Spencer. Then the Running Rebels live up to their name. Three passes later, David Butler jams it. Number four, UNLV outruns 16-ranked Louisville, 91-81.
Those are Louisville sluggers. And out in South Bend, Indiana, Notre Dame gave sixth-ranked